So, you know, in order to really unlock that full value of video, you have really been leaning in, and NBC Universal is creating a lot of capabilities. You were early at doing that. What are some of those capabilities and products that you have available to enable us to unlock the full value of video in your ecosystem?
Well, we're doing a bunch of things, and I think it falls into three areas. The first and most important priority or initiative we're doing at NBC Universal is continuing to invest in the content that you spoke about a few minutes ago, whether it's 4, 5, 10 times the power or impact for our advertisers' messages count, so we need to have as much of it as possible. From the Olympics to making more scripted television than any other company or more than we've ever made in the last decade, we'll continue to do that. So that's one thing. The second thing also is investing in our data and analytics capabilities to actually prove that ROI to you. So as many of you in the audience or you know, that with the impact of technology and the continuing addition or incremental choice that consumers have, getting the media mix for a content provider and an advertiser is more and more complex. So we're able to bring all of the mix or all of the different choices that you have together to measure and prove out that ROI. So we've developed a lot of products at NBC Universal to enable you to do that. And I think the last piece is really an acknowledgement and an aggressive leaning in partnerships. Because if we didn't form those partnerships, we wouldn't be able to tell you that we're aware that you have to invest in other places to push content out, push advertising messages out, and we wouldn't be able to do that if we didn't have great partners like some of my friends from AOL in the room or our strategic investments in BuzzFeed and Vox Media. So I think it's a combination of those three things that acknowledge the complexity in the changing marketplace.
So clear you're doing that to create benefit, right? Benefit for your organization, but benefit for your clients as well. What are some of those benefits on both sides, on the supply side, you know, and the demand side?
Well, I think the benefits are, particularly if you even rewound as what seems to be recent history, 3, 5 years, particularly some legacy media companies were much more precious about their brands, our brands, and their content. So I think the benefits are, in the same way that advertisers have to do, we have to become less precious and share our brands and actually push them out across all platforms. So I think that that's been a great benefit, because then it's actually quite liberating when you see that the interaction with the consumer is so, it increases human touch time. They stay with your content longer, therefore the engagement is right. And if you could get the contextual marriage right between the content and the advertiser message, that's where the magic happens. So I think that's the benefit for all of us around as we continue to try to navigate how do we make sure we can prove that ROI for our marketing clients.
Fantastic. One of the things that, you know, we're obviously here in Cannes, we're talking about this topic. We talk about this in top-to-top conversations as well. Certainly my leadership team is engaged in these, but I run an agency of almost 1,000 people in the U.S. You run a large organization. You're talking to hundreds of clients, multiple agencies. What are you guys doing? Because this is new, and it's not necessarily always very easy to kind of get your head wrapped around this. And there's a lot of, you know, a lack of inertia. People really feeling much more comfortable doing what they've always done, knowing that they need to change, but perhaps not knowing exactly how to do that. So what are you guys doing to help educate or evangelize these new capabilities and services? What are you doing within agencies? What are you doing with clients?
Well, it's really interesting, particularly this week. We've been having conversations that are about two very specific things, and every meeting has been, quite frankly, the same. And one of them is all about the content. Obviously, we're here at a creative conference, and because we've been so aggressive about expanding our content opportunities, it's really probably the number one headline that starts any meeting. What are you doing in addition to expanding your relationship with the NFL, or in addition to you expanding the original content? How do we get connected as partners earlier on, right? But I think the other thing that's been overwhelming conversation is the data and analytics piece, which is NBC Universal has been very, very aggressive, I'll say, in the television industry, only to connect it back to your question, which is lack of inertia and legacy. This is the way we always do it. And as an industry, and if any of you are familiar with anything we've been doing or saying, if we don't force the evolution of measurement in our entire industry, that would be the worst thing that could ever happen. Because when you are held to this legacy of a, what we in the TV industry call a C3 measurement, which actually does nothing for your ROI, it doesn't move product off the shelf. So if we're sitting there waiting 3 weeks to find out an age and gender maybe measurement only on the one screen in your living room, right, doesn't even comprehend the screen in your hand, or God forbid the screen in your lap, we can't really accomplish the business goals that we want to achieve. So that's why over the last 4 years, NBC Universal has invested hundreds of millions of dollars in giving all of us the courage to reach out beyond those legacy measurement or rules to say, let me help you sell some darn product.
So we've had a couple of conversations.
We're very like-minded on this issue.
On the measurement piece, I think we absolutely need to blow that up. I think at the same time, there's the ability to understand that total audience viewership across streaming and traditional VOD and so on. I think there's another question on the ability to monetize that for clients. And, you know, I'm just interested because, you know, clearly we've seen some research and through different suppliers that are helping us understand what that total audience actually does look like and the value of that content. I'm also curious on the fact that, you know, what we're seeing is commercial load has been getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And I think we're now seeing some companies taking some steps to reduce the number of commercials within a pod and looking, as you said, to other opportunities to allow brands. So instead of reducing the supply, looking at other areas to allow brands to engage, whether that's integrations, whether that's development into the story arc, whether that's streaming video. So what traction are you seeing in some of these new opportunities and new capabilities?
Well, I think we're seeing a lot of traction in that area. I think we have to define. Because saying that people are reducing the commercial load, some of those companies that are reducing the commercial load really took advantage of the consumer. Because of fragmentation and the reduction in rating points that have become available, they really pushed the envelope too far and just said, let me load up some more commercials in there. Luckily, NBC Universal is not one of those companies that did that, but the television industry as a whole, I think, got really aggressive and disrespected the consumer experience. So that added to the current situation that we're in right now. So the consumer experience has become the a real big priority, and particularly in one of the spaces that you're talking about in the VOD space, right? So you see an enhanced consumer experience when there's the ability to have a reduced commercial load. And if you do it right, and if you're able to really create original content that lives in that VOD space, that enhances the experience with that content that's on live linear, you're really going to extend the lifespan of your messages. And particularly, something really great happened in this past season as the broadcast networks picked up all their new shows for the fall season. They pushed really aggressively with the studios to pick up full in-season stacking rights. So you're going to see an increased population of content in VOD, right? So the consumer has access to much more content that can be monetized for all of us, right? In this room, and you're gonna see there's fewer commercial load, and you're seeing a lot more branded content, original content developed to get connected to that content. Really exciting.
Fantastic. Thank you, Glenda.